Hello, hello, hello. Today is June 27, 2021. Yesterday was June 26. I published problem number 113. And the problem was as follows, typical high school problem. This is the ground, horizontal. Here's a building. The height of the building is 3.0 meters, to an accuracy of a few millimeters. Here is a roof. On the roof is here a target, 2.0 meters from the edge of the roof. And this distance is also known to a few millimeters. The distance from me to the wall is 10 meters, also known to an accuracy of a few millimeters. I throw an object, it's very small, only a few millimeters. I throw an object in such a way that it hits this target here. But I can do that in many different ways. But I want to do it with the minimum possible value of alpha. If this is the direction that I shoot it, this is alpha. So the question is, what is the minimum value of alpha? And we were all going to use 9.81 meters per second square. Little did you know that the answer of the minimum value of alpha is independent of g. We'll get to that. Now, the problem is that you have to clear this point here. If you shoot too low, it will hit this wall. So the parabola for which alpha would be the smallest value, that parabola has three known points. This point, which is x equals 0, y equals 0. This point, which it must clear, x equals 10, y equals 3, x equals 10, y equals 3, and this point here, x equals 12, and y equals 3. Those three points must lie on that parabola. Well, the parabola has the shape y equals ax squared plus bx plus c. Substitute in here y is 0 and x is 0, because it must be consistent with this equation, tells you immediately that c must be 0. So you satisfy this condition. Now, you put in for y 3, and you put in for x 10, so you get 100. X squared is 100 times a plus 10b, because x is 10. But you also must satisfy this condition, that when x is 12, y is 3. So that gives you 3 is 144a plus 12b. Two equations with two unknowns. Piece of cake. High school physics. High school math, I should say. A equals minus 1 over 40. B equals plus 0.55. So the equation of the parabola in units of meters is y equals minus 1 over 40 times x squared plus 0.5 times x. The tangent of the angle alpha, right here at x equals 0, is dy dx. And when you take dy dx of this equation, and then substitute for x equals 0, you end up with 0.55. So the tangent of alpha, which is the smallest value possible, is 0.55. Alpha, 28.8 degrees. The good news is, already I know that now, because I have seen your answers for already a day, that more than 50% of you, roughly 50%, have the correct answer. They have 28.8 0.8 degrees. What is a shocker, maybe, that it's independent of G. I never used G. So I've plotted this equation right here. So you see here x equals 0, x equals 1, x equals 2, x equals 3 meters, 4 meters, 5 meters, 6 meters, 7 meters, 8 meters, 9 meters, 10 meters, right at 3, it just clears the edge of the roof. And at 12, it's again at 3. Now, what is obvious that at x equals 11, that must be the highest point of the parabola, because it is plus 3 here, and it is plus 3 there. So this must be the highest point of the parabola. At x equals 11, that y point, I plotted it to scale, so you can hardly see it, is only 2.5 centimeters above the roof. All right. So to calculate the minimum value for alpha, I would say it's trivial. What I didn't ask you, but what I could have asked you, what is the velocity V0 at that angle 28.8 degrees, when it just clears this point and hits the target? For that, that is dependent on G, by the way. So let's take a look at that. High school physics, y is the y component of the velocity, which is V0 sine alpha times the time, t is 0 right here, minus 1 half g t squared. Classic high school. In the x direction, there is no acceleration, so the displacement x at time t is the x component of the velocity, which is V0 cosine alpha times the time. And so at any moment t, I can substitute for t x at that moment divided by V0 cosine alpha. And I do that. In this equation, I eliminate t and I replace t by x of t divided by V0 cosine alpha. That then gives me this equation. This is one equation with one unknown, that is V0, provided that you use my G of 9.81. And so you will find then that it is 15.99 meters per second. Yeah. Isn't that interesting? You know y t at that point. You know x at that point. You know the tangent of alpha, because we calculated that. Alpha is 28.8 degrees, so you find immediately V0 squared. And so you find V0. Now, some of you argue, yeah, this is a nice solution, but if that object has the size of a few millimeters, not clear that it will clear the edge of the roof. So, yeah, okay, I think it is not that important to go into that in detail, but I went one step further. I made alpha 29.0 degrees, just a hair larger, but I adjust the speed so that it still hits this point. So now it hits, it clears this edge here just by a little bit, and that little bit is 7 millimeters. So in going from 28.8 to 29.0, you clear this point by 0.7 millimeters. Now comes something that may not be so obvious to you. And that is, suppose I make the angle of alpha quite large. I'm not interested in this point anymore, because I make alpha so large that I always clear this point, but of course I must hit that point. That is a necessary condition. So I get the parabola which goes like this. Bingo. I have calculated that for 50 degrees. So I make alpha 50 degrees and I adjust the speed so that I hit this point. What do you think now? Will that speed be higher than 15.99 meters per second? Or will it be lower than 15.99 seconds? So the object goes way higher and then hits this point. What may surprise you, that the speed V0 is then lower than the 15. What did we have? The 15.99. It turns out to be 12.3 meters per second. That's not so intuitive, isn't it? Because you think, oh my, I go so way much higher, so it costs more energy, so it has to be more kinetic energy. No? Less. 50 degrees, hits here, clears this, speed is only 12.3 meters per second. I think this is a wonderful problem because it has so many aspects, and the real issue, of course, is, and many of you have that, to recognize that the parabola for which alpha is a minimum must go to the three points that you know. It must go to 0, 0, it must go to 10, 0, 10, 3, and it must go to 12, 3. That gives you then immediately the solution. All right then, today is June 27th, so I'm not planning to post it very shortly, maybe 4, 5, 6 days from now. But as I said, the good news is that about 50% of you have it right. And the other 50% better study my solutions, because it is a little bit embarrassing if you had any physics in high school, if you can't do that. Does it mean that you will no longer be my friends? Of course not. That has nothing to do with it. You will always be my friends, regardless of whether you ace this problem or whether you can't do it at all. Makes no difference to me, but it may make a difference for you. So you may have to brush up on very basic trajectory. Have a nice day and take care. I would like to add a few more comments related to the solution of problem 113. Unless it is specifically stated in a problem, we always ignore air drag in the case of trajectories when we throw an object up in the room or in our laboratory at a certain speed. However, in reality, of course, there is always air drag, and the air drag lowers the speed. And so our trajectories are not perfect, but they may be very good approximations. Clearly, in our problem, we have also assumed that there would be no air drag, and so the 28.8 degrees is perfect. In lecture 12 of 801, I cover air drag. It's very complicated. Air drag depends on the shape of the object, the density of the object, the speed of the object. In fact, it has two terms. It has one term linear in speed, which is called the viscous term, and it has one proportional to V square, which is called the pressure term. When you drive your car at 60 kilometers per hour, you create a wind on your windshield of 60 kilometers per hour. That air drag term, which is the V-square term which dominates, is entirely the force that you have to overcome. That's why you need your gasoline. That term is enormous. In lecture 12, Dave Pooley, my graduate student, calculated
very accurately, nasty calculation, the air drag on a pebble that we throw, I believe, from 100 meters altitude. I don't remember the altitude, but it is in lecture 12. He takes the V term into account and the V square term into account. And of course, you also have to take into account, in the case of the pebble, that the speed changes when you throw a pebble, and you have to take the change of the speed into account. In the case of our bullet, when we shoot up the bullet at time t0, its speed is about 50 kilometers per hour. By the time it reaches the roof, it's about 45 kilometers per hour. Not much different, but it's different. If you really want to make an attempt to make a rough estimate of the air drag in the case of our bullet, be my guest. You may then assume that the bullet is spherical. That already is an assumption, because remember, air drag depends on shape. And you may then assume that the diameter is about 4 millimeters, BB bullet, and that its weight is about, its mass is about 0.3 grams. Be my guest. But if you do that, you will see that indeed at 28.8 degrees, when you shoot it up at an original speed of 16 meters per second, it will hit the wall. How much lower it will be below the edge of the roof that we have to clear, I do not know. I cannot even make a rough guess. But I'm beginning to like more and more my 29.0 degrees for the minimum angle, because in the absence of any air drag, then my bullet would pass the edge of the roof 7 millimeters higher than when it enters the roof. And that's something, 7 millimeters. Maybe the 7 millimeters is just enough to compensate for air drag. I have no clue. And I hope you don't have any clue either. I just wanted to mention this. We always ignore air drag, but even though it can be small, and therefore the calculations that we make in the absence of air drag are quite accurate, they are never precise.